What's up, peers, and welcome to the World Crypto Network, where we continue our reading of the Bitcoin Optech Group newsletter today, number 24, on December 4th, 2018. This week's newsletter describes a proposal to tweak Bitcoin Core's relay policy for related transactions to help simplify on-chain fees for Lightning Network payments, mentions upcoming meetings about the Lightning Network protocol, and briefly describes the new LND release and work towards a Bitcoin Core maintenance release. Action items. Bitcoin Core is preparing for upcoming maintenance release version 0.17.1. Maintenance releases include bug fixes, backports of minor features. Anyone intending to take this version is encouraged to review the list of backported fixes and help with testing when a release candidate is made available. News. Child pays for parent carve-out. In order to spend Bitcoin, the transaction where you receive those Bitcoin must be added to the blockchain somewhere before your spending transaction. That addition can be in previous blocks, or it can be earlier in the same block as the spending transaction. This protocol requirement means that a spending transaction with a high fee rate can, through averaging, make it profitable to mine its unconfirmed parent transaction, even if that parent has a lower fee rate. This is called child pays for parent. Child pays for parent even works for multiple descendant transactions, but the more relationships that need to be considered, the longer it takes a node to create the most profitable possible block template for miners to work on. For this reason, Bitcoin Core limits the maximum number of size of related transactions. For users fee bumping their own transaction, these limits are high enough to rarely cause problems, but for users of multi-party protocols, a malicious counterparty can exploit these limits to prevent an honest user from being able to fee bump a transaction. This can be a major problem for protocols like Lightning Network that rely on time locks. If a transaction is not confirmed before that time lock expires, the counterparty can take back some or all of the funds they previously paid. To help solve this problem, Matt Carolla has suggested a change to the child pays for parent policy to carve out or reserve some space for small transactions that only has one ancestor in the mempool. All of its other ancestors must already be in the blockchain. This accompanies a proposal for Lightning Network described in the news section of last week's newsletter number 23, where Lightning Network would mostly ignore on-chain fees, except for cooperative closes of channels, and use child pays for parent fee bumping to choose the fee when the channel was closed, reducing complexity and improving safety. However, to make this safe for Lightning Network, no matter how high the fees get, nodes need to be able to also support relaying packages of transactions that include both low fee rate ancestor plus high fee rate descendants in a way that does not cause the node to automatically reject the earlier transaction as being too cheap, and so not to see the subsequent fee bumping. Whereas the carve-out policy is probably easy to implement, package relay is something that's been discussed for a long time without it being formally specified or implemented. Organization of Lightning Network 1.1 specification effort. And although Lightning Network protocol developers decide which efforts they want to work on for the next major version of the common protocol, they're still working on developing and coming to agreement on the exact specifications for those protocols. Rusty Rossell is organizing meetings to help speed up the specification process and has started a thread asking for feedback about what medium to use for meetings, Google Hangouts, IRC meeting, or something else, and how formal to make these meetings. Anyone planning to participate in the process is recommended to at least monitor the thread. The release of LND version 0.5.1 is released as a new minor version with improvements particularly focused on its support of Neutrino, a lightweight SPV wallet mode that LND can work with to make Lightning Network payments without having to directly use a full node. This release also fixes an accounting bug for users of the BTC wallet backend, where not all change payments to yourself may have been reflected in your displayed balance. Upon upgrading, a rescan on the blockchain will be performed so that the missing accounting information is recovered and your correct balance will be displayed. No funds were at risk. They just weren't tracked correctly. The Bitcoin Core project is planning to start tagging release candidates for maintenance version 0.17.1 soon. This is expected to resolve some bugs with build system incompatibilities on recent Linux distributions, as well as fix other minor issues. Notable code changes this week in Bitcoin Core, LND, C-Lightning, and Libstack 256K1. LND commit stores the most recent channel re-establishment message in the node's database so that it can be reset even after a channel has been closed. This improves the node's chance of recovering from a connectivity problem combining with partial data loss. A Bitcoin Core merge adds a new DESC file to the get address info, list unspent, and scantx output set RPC with the output script descriptor for each address when the wallet has enough information to consider the address solvable. An address is solvable when a program knows enough about its script public key, optionally redeem script, and optionally witness script in order for the program to generate an unsigned input spending funds sent to that address. A new solvable field is added to the get address info RPC to independently indicate that the wallet knows how to solve for that address. The new DESC fields are not expected to be particularly useful at the moment as they are currently can only be used with the scantx outset RPC, but they will provide a compact way of providing all the information necessary for making addresses solvable to future and upgraded RPCs for Bitcoin Core, such as those used for interactions between offline and online, that is cold or hot wallets, multisig wallets, CoinJoin implementations, and other use cases. LND node commit adds RPCs that allow signing a transaction template where some inputs are controlled by LND. Although this particular tool mirrors functionality already provided by the LN Wallet Signer service, the mechanism used to enable this new service makes it possible for developers to extend the RPC or gRPC provided through LND with gRPCs provided by other code on the local machine or even a remote service. Several additional new services using these mechanisms are planned for the near future. And there's also included a footnote on Bitcoin Core's ancestor and descendant depth limit. Peers, subscribe to the Bitcoin Optech newsletter and get all this information for free and Libre as it should be. Thank you very much to all the contributors and sponsors of the Bitcoin Optech news group. And peers, thank you very much for watching and bye-bye.